took Wambugu apples to Moi University in Eldoret, Uasin Gishu County, and it was well received. The institution resolved to establish apple farming on 2,000 acres of their land. We were here to launch this mega project where the chief guest was the Principal Secretary of State Department for University Education and Research, Ambassador Simon Nabukwesi. We were warmly welcomed and served with a delicious breakfast. On this particular day, the PS was also launching CCTV system and a state-of-the-art laboratory in the institution.
Round of applause again. So much. So that is ERP. This is the CCTV. Round of applause for the CCTV. Thank you so much.
What can be done anywhere in any corner of the world can be done right here. And I'm very happy that you have done it right here. Professor, I want to thank you with your team that you have done it right here. It just requires the right thinking, the right attitude, the right personnel, the right level of commitment, and we get anything that any human being can do anywhere in this world done here in Kenya. And I know, like the ICT team that has been introduced, starting with yourself, you are very young people. You are the people who will transform this country. So keep on track. Maintain your focus. Maintain your right attitude. Keep doing, and you'll make this country a better place. I thank you for making Moi University a better place in terms of digitizing everything.
Then came the big moment, the launch of Wambugu Apples project at the university's farm. This project is aimed at generating income, and if successful, it will enable the institution to sustain itself without depending on the government for allocations.
In this exercise of launching by our peers the planting of apples as a way of mobilizing resources for the university to make our university sustainable going forward in the future. It's a big exercise that the council has approved that we continue with it. And this is a special apple called the Wambuka apple, which has been tested to be the best in the world with a lot of demand from Europe and other places in the world. So I would want to welcome everybody. Moi University is working towards actually mobilizing resources to be self-sustainable outside the exchequer.
Hii miti nilibarikiwa ni Mungu kutoa kwa msitu. Hakujulikana ni mtu yene. Sidio? Na vile tuliagana na chairman, kaja naye. Sasa nikamwambia sasa unaleta maneno mazuri kwa ajili tutaendelea nchi yetu iwe tajiri. Hii muti nilitoa kwa msitu nikauganisha 4-in-1. Nilikuta miti ni 4. Nikauganisha siku kwenda shule ya mtu. Ni Mungu tu alinipatia hiyo mawaidha. Nikaendelea naye kutoka 1985 mpaka leo tunaendelea na watu wangu nyumba yako. Sasa tunaendelea naye tunageuza nchi yetu ama nchi ya nje. Kwa ajili sasa hata nashukuru Mungu Moi University kuchukua hii mali. Tuseme ni mpesa vile chairman anasema. Kwa ajili hii matunda inachukuliwa kwa chaba na matunda 5 tunauza 500. Si ndio? Si tunauza kwa chaba. Na sasa nikitaka tuendelee hata wananchi. Nikiomba PS, bwana PS. Sasa uendelee kuchikilia hii pamoja na financial yako na chairman. Hii mambo tupanue baka hii machaba tuone kama itajaza watu hapa. Muko na maneno mnaekelewa ni Mungu mikono. Kwa ajili kuna hata tunazuia kwenda nje sasa. Tanaambia keti wangu huyu ni mchana wangu ndio anakuja haka. Sijawahi kuja hapa lakini nilimwambia yeye ndio utakuja kwangu. Utakuwa miguu yangu upeleke nje. Sasa vile chairman alikuja nilimwambia hata jazubui. Sasa kazi ile tunapewa ni Moi University. Sidio? Na wananchi wa hapa. Sidio? Wapade. Muwe matajiri. Tuondokee mumaskini. Sasa kwa ajili sasa nchi yetu tuko na tabu. Sidio? Ndio. Msiamini mahindi. Mahindi ni mzuri upande ya kukula. Lakini hii miti inazaa mara 4 kwa mwaka. Mimi namwambia hivyo kwa ajili ni mzee, mimi mzee. Na kazi yangu inashukuriwa ni hawa. Sidio? Tusaidie mno. Mimi hawana chagua mtu. Sidio? Tulitoka mikononi ya Mungu. Mungu alisema na Yesu na Roho. Kujeni tuombe Sidio? Tuombe mtu. Ni wewe na mimi. Ni lugha tofauti. Lakini tuko pamoja. Tupendane, tuendelee na kazi.
To start by recognizing the owner of the products that we want to grow on this farm, that is Wambugu. Because I think he has gone through a long journey in developing a product which we as a university recognize as a solution to the financial problems or challenges that we are facing in the institution, and at the same time as a product which is going to change and transform the community in this area. So thank you very much, Wambugu, for the work you've done. Two, I want to say and recognize the vision of the council through the chair, because what we are implementing is the vision of the chair and the council. Having come with this idea is a very noble idea. And I wish to add by saying that apple farming in this university and in this region is an idea whose time has come, and I think this is the right time. I want to specifically talk about what we have been doing at the farm here, and I'll start with the resources we have. We have land, very good land. We're able to test the soils here to see if they are suitable for apple growing. Their sea acid level is good for apple growing. The nutrient level in the soils is good. We're able to test this and we're able to confirm it's good for apple growing. So the land is okay for growing apples. This land where we are located is stretching all the way from up there and is going all the way downstream, close to 100 acres. And this is the area where we have identified to start from. And we will continue expanding as time goes. We have good labor, very well-trained personnel at the university who have the know-how, who will be able to take care of crop to make sure it is able to mature and be able to access the market. We have good quantities of water. We have a falls up there, so we are tapping water which is already flowing by gravity. So this area is going to be irrigated through gravity, and currently we are using a pipe which is able to deliver 6,000 liters of water per hour. We have also dug a pump up here which has the capacity of 1,500 square meters, cubic meters. That is going to be a reservoir which you can use in case we can't access water from the falls up there. So far we have dug 21,000 holes. We intend to go up to 60,000 holes. That will cover 100 acres.
Wana PA, the Vice Chancellor of Moi University and the Council of Moi University and all protocols of the afternoon. Yeah, my name is Katrin Wambogo, and I'm an ambassador of Wambogo Upwards, and I can say I can give myself a max 9 out of 10 because Moi University got born again when I preached to them. Hallelujah. Amen. So I really thank God because of Moi University, because of accepting the idea that God gave my father, and also embracing it, and really worked with this to the rest of my life, because the trees have been here for 100 years. So I think I will give that this is the founder, the person who found this apple is my father, and he came up with the idea. Yes, so we can appreciate him. Thank you so much. So that's my father. So thank you so much, and we are going to give our surety to Moi University and to the VC and also to the council that we are going to follow this project. We are going to work together anytime you are called away, and also anytime we'll be coming to the university and giving all ideas that can make this work more better. And I really thank God because of VC. Thank you so much, sir. You've been there for us. A call, you just pick our call. You're so humble. Thank you so much. And I think we are giving us we are really looking forward to this project, making it here in Eldoret, and also the people around. And we thank God because of now we have big market out there, that we have Spain, we have Switzerland, and we have Netherlands, who we are going to connect more university, because they have the capacity to supply them. So that's a big supply that we have. That's the biggest market we have currently. And also we have local demand that we are supposed to supply, but with more university, we are proud of now supplying to the demand that we have. So thank you so much for the opportunity even to arrive here. Even if I sikufika university, nisikie mtu akisema even my father hajaienda university, we are here today. So we are graduating. So in history, tulienda university. Ama atuko? Yes, hata mimi nimeingia university. So God bless you, Bwana Pia. Really appreciate for your presence. I can imagine the distance between me and you. Thank you so much. Like I have the government at my hand. So thank you. And when you go there, tell them we have a new gospel, Wambogo Apples. Thank you so much.
Bwana PS, Ambassador Simon Nabukweza. Nabukwesi. I'm allowed because you know where I'm coming from. The members of the council, the management of Moi University, and all the stakeholders, all protocols observed. Good afternoon. I want to talk about apple farming. And allow me to say this. I only worked for 1 year. And I was in charge of Meru, Isioro, and Marsabit. I'm a land economist. That's my first degree. I was a big person then. And I had a GK and a driver and all the facilities. But I chose to retire myself to go to business. I've never worked any other time. I've been in business, and out of business, I did an MBA. It became very interesting, and I did a PhD in entrepreneurship. Very interesting. And my PhD is not not scholarly. It's actual, because I see opportunities. Entrepreneurship is about seeing opportunities when other people are seeing darkness. Seeing a gold mine when other people are seeing stones. Besides my other studies, and I'm happy because at times I address scholars. I'm a doctor. And when I'm in my university, please don't call me a doctor. I'm doctor. Because I also have a PhD in law. So I'm happy that I'm addressing scholars. And at times people question scholars because they are not able to operationalize what they stand for. I came to my university and I was told we have a debt of 4.5 billion. We owe pension about 2.6 billion. And universities in Kenya, public universities, when our peers are international beggars, because all the time we are knocking at your door. Tupatie. And this is where they train entrepreneurs, this is where they train distinguished scholars. And now we are on spotlight from IMF. More universities, one of the universities on spotlight. But financial problems. Appears. This council, you'll be the first council, unless they are let down by the Moi fraternity, to tell the government in the next 4 years, we don't need your money. You can keep your money. You can keep your? The only people who can let us down are these people. I want to be very honest. Because I say facts and figures don't lie. And today, I want to talk about this apple farming. This is a Bogo man. Don't ask me why I got him. I told you I'm an entrepreneur. And when I walked to his farm, and I saw what I saw, na akaniambia pahali ametoka na pahali amefika, na vile anauza hii matuda yake Ghana, Zimbabwe, Ethiopia, Holland, Spain, Nigeria, na hapa Kenya, bado tuko hapo. Ni kama mtu amegudua M-Pesa, lakini inaendelea nchi za ngambo. I feel pity for this country. And he showed me all the documentation, including from Kali, that he is the best apple in the world. And then he took me through the journey from 1985, from a houseboy. I told him, Mzee, I work with you because you don't know whom you are talking to. You are talking to a doctor in entrepreneurship. Hata sijui kama alikuwa anaelewa doctor ni nini entrepreneurship. Today I have studied this apple, Wabogo apple, because he has even a trademark and everything, cafes, HDA, all those certificates and so on. And I can assure you, Bona PS, there is nobody they can compare in the growing of apple in this country. He's in a class of his own. And I will repeat the statistics so that you can know why I'm so passionate about this apple. And those who are, because I don't even know what you are doing. If you get into this apple farming, you are going to retire and start growing apple. Because, and I'm about to demonstrate. And I know because you are scholars, you are very fast at facts and figures. I said that this one apple seedling, from the figures he has given me, and I've done my due diligence, on maturity, because it's a fast growing variety of apple. It starts fruiting at 9 months. Today I talk like I'm a bow. By second year, by third year, fourth year, full maturity. This plant, if you listen to them, because we have an MOU with them, they are going to be with us for up to 6 years. We have another study. They have assured us, when at full maturity, at 4 years, if you have taken care of these seedlings, you have given it the manure, Professor Salem, umeipatia manure, umeipatia maji, and you have looked after it, the way you look at your cows, and the way you look at your maize, optimum results, this plant should give you 2,000 apples. Those apples you are seeing, those people that you are holding, 2,000 apples per plant. And 2,000 apples, Mzee tells me, minimum you expect from 1 kg of apple is 400 shillings. He's selling at 500. Export is even better. So if you divide 2,000 apples from one plant, divide by 6, because 6 apples will give you a kg. That gives you 333 kgs. 333 kgs, if you multiply by 400, it gives you 133,000 per plant. Kenya shillings. I'm talking about Kenya shillings. Not Uganda shilling or Tanzania shilling. Kenya shilling. Pesa. 133,000 shillings. Per plant. Serem can tell you, per acre, you are supposed to plant 600 plants. So multiply 133,000 times 600 plants. You get 79 million per acre. Yes. I have not called the PS here to joke around. I've called here because I'm asking him for money. Yeah. I'm asking the PS, please assist my university to grow 1,000 acres. Die with us. Walk with us in this journey. We shall not embarrass you. So, if you are talking about 79 million per acre, right now we are doing 100 acres. Multiply 79 million times 100. What figures are you getting? 79 billion per 100 acres. Imagine more university in the next years with the 79 billion. I will bring down all these structures and come up with modern Harvard structures. Yeah, I'll have the best university in Africa. This council will be a model council. Huyu mzee atapatiwa honorary doctorate because of creativity and innovation in agriculture. Supposing the PS accepts, because we are asking him, kindly Bona PS, we have already met him, we have already talked to him, and he is here, because we are telling the PS, give us 700 million so that we can do 500 acres. So you can imagine 8 billion times 5. Can you multiply those figures? Yeah? How much? 400
billion.
Supposing we do 1,000 acres, because I have another investor here, of God. Why is Eden? Come here, I want you to say something. I've been looking for money. Where is Eden? Yeah, I want him to come so that you can say, come here. Don't worry, come. I will not embarrass you. I'm a serious Kenyan. This is an investor, of God. From Turkey, come. Okay, so don't get a kid. So, what am I saying? Hey, 400 billion, if 1,000 times 2, 800 billion for Moi University, what business would Moi University have asking for money from the Kenya government?
I'm delighted to be here with you, particularly having been invited as a guest to launch three projects today, one of which is agricultural and aims to assist the university to generate revenue to boost the financial stability of this university. Of course, it is important for us to know that one responsibility of the council is to mobilize resources. And I'm very impressed that the chairman, who has just spoken on behalf of the council, has taken it up together with the council members to go flat out to mobilize resources. And one way of mobilizing resources is to partner with the people who have solid and viable ideas like Mzee Wambugu and with Aden to get things done in the university to make it financially sustainable. I'm very happy. The new council is moving fast. They have not been in office for so long, but we can feel their dream. It is a viable dream. It is a valid dream. I want to invite all stakeholders and the entire university fraternity to join the council in working with the council and the chair of the council in this dream, so that together we reach that desirable destination. According to the chairman of the council, and he's a very pragmatic person, we can be there in 4 years. Of course, the government does everything possible to fund education from basic education, in fact, early learning, basic education, TVET education, then university education. The government does its best. In fact, university students know that they paid more fees at high school than they are paying fees at university level. That is the generosity of government, and is the commitment of government to maintain low fees at university level so that everybody can afford university education, where you get into specialized training to be a person of value to our nation, to this region, and to humanity. So investing in farming the way the university wants to do in collaboration with Mr. Wambugu and with all the facts and figures about the Wambugu apple is a projection into where we want to be in the next few years. At the ministry, we have always encouraged our institutions to find ways and means to become financially stable by creating other sources of resources so that we reach those standards that universities in America, in Europe, in some countries in Asia have reached. As a PS University Education, people who know me keep asking for scholarships. This kind of project is what assists a university to create scholarships. If the project will be as productive as we are projecting it to be, as explained by the chairman, then there will be a lot of resources that can be shared to departments. And a department can identify the best of the students from anywhere in the country, anywhere in the world, to bring them over, because such students will be innovative, like those I've been seeing today. And that's what improves the profile of the university. Many of the scholarships we get are given by individual universities. They give to the government to give to friendly governments where they choose to establish partnerships. When you hear that 100 students are going to Hungary every year from Kenya, they're not going to one university. The money being paid is not from the government. It's from individual universities that have raised money. So we can also raise money to pay fees for students in form of scholarships. We can raise money to pay researchers so that there are high-flying researchers to become champions of research, innovation, and even creation of new ideas in academia. I know that sometimes lecturers are not motivated because there is no reward. There is no monetary reward for what you do. And sometimes even we don't talk about it, we just keep quiet. It looks normal and it dies. So we look like we don't have so much to offer. Yet there is so much if there is appropriate motivation in place. And I want to think that Moi University is going to set the pace. It's going to be a role model for others to follow, so that in future, we don't read articles in the papers about lack of funds in universities, but we talk about overflowing funds in the universities that are being put to good use to motivate our scholars. When we talk about the sovereignty of a country, we talk about greatness of a country, we talk about visibility of a country, we talk about our scholars, people who are resourceful, and we are resourceful at different levels. Like the late Philip Ocheng said, he went to America to study. He went with the late Obama and many others. They went and studied and came with certificates. And he wrote this article himself. For him, he went to class, but he also drank beer. And because of not attending enough lessons to qualify to get a certificate, he came back with knowledge without a certificate. And he used that knowledge to earn a living until he died recently. So knowledge can be acquired in so many ways. And as you've been told, Mzee Wambugu has created this knowledge. And he has brought it forth to partner with the university. Adan is here. He's a young man, but with a lot of knowledge, with a lot of networks, a lot of connections to connect and partner with the university to also improve facilities in the university, including this investment in Apple Farm, as well as hostel facilities. And I want to encourage you students that while you are in the university, create a culture for more university. Create a culture. Read about universities out there. Read about universities out there. Even we grown-ups, people boast about the universities they went to because of the living culture that the university has. don't live in areas where you mingle with the people who are not of your level and the culture you desire to have. Those of us who have interacted with other people know that we are very different from other people. We from East Africa are very different from those from West Africa. And we are fairly different from those from Southern Africa. And we are very different from those in North Africa. And of course, we are different from those in Central Africa. We are different. And we are proud to be from East Africa. And of course, as Kenyans, we'd want to be proud of ourselves. And you young people are the ones who are with all the potential to assist us transform this country. I want to encourage you to create a culture as you may be guided by the deans, by your lecturers, and by the university leadership. It will be good for us. I don't want to say so much. I want to emphasize the dream that the chairman and the council have. It's the dream to progress. And the dream that is not just left at that level. It goes with action. And the action is what we want to do right now. I want to emphasize the importance of the management working with the council the way you are working, Vice Chancellor. If you work the way you are working, Moi University will be the university that the late President Moi envisioned. He wanted this to be a model university because it was not a university college of any other university. It was properly thought out, it was designed and properly established. But the university spread out itself and it spread out thin on the ground because it had campuses all over. This is the time for recollection, for refocusing, so that we develop in the way that we want this university to be. And I'm happy that the council and management of the university and the entire university fraternity is working together to dream this dream of putting Moi University where it is supposed to be, so that the brand can stand out for other people to emulate. Let us dream this dream. Let us follow this dream until we actualize it. I wish you the very best, Mr. Chairman. And I promise and commit to give full support to this good dream. Asante sana.
After the event, we went to Eldoret Town with the chairman of the Council of Moi University, Dr. Humphrey Njuguna, a group of former workers of Moi University who had recently retired. We are having a workshop where the chairman got the chance to talk to them about venturing into apple farming as they retire.
I want to support this apple farming. And in 4 years' time, then that will be the best council ever in the history of Moi University, turning around the fortunes. So I'm here to turn around the fortunes. I hope then we live here. Those who are able, you'll be able to plant 10, 20. Okay? Because I would want to introduce apple, this variety of apple in Kenya, the way tea was introduced in Kenya in 1993, the way coffee was introduced in this country, the way avocado was introduced in this country. And I'm telling you, I'm only talking about the fruits. What if Moi can start up a factory where they're able to do apple vinegar, they're able to do winery, they're able to do other byproducts. Now, Mzee Ametuambia, I have market in Holland, I have market in Spain, I have market in Switzerland. You can't, even if you planted 3,000 apples, acres of apples, you can't satisfy the market I have.